everyone. Thanks for clicking on this video. We are Access Hockey. She's Rachel.
Hi.
I'm Janae.
Hi.
I'm Janae, and you clicked on this video presumably because you want to learn more about the new Detroit Red Wings head coach.
Who doesn't?
We have a head coach.
Yay.
Isn't that great? We were so lost for so long. I'm just kidding. We were fine. It's fine.
We're so lost for this whole offseason.
Before we keep going, make sure you like this video, subscribe to our channel, ring the bell for notifications for when we have a new video so you don't miss it. And if you could comment below, we'd love to hear from you. We love to read those and to respond to them. So let's get into it, talking about Derek Lalonde, the 28th head coach of the Detroit Red Wings.
And I feel like we're pretty good with this timing because it was actually like super recent. We've been draft talking, so click on our previous videos for draft prospect profiles.
Because that's this coming week, draft week.
Oh my goodness.
Is that not insane?
It is insane.
We'll get going.
So Derek Lalonde, if you are not aware or familiar with him.
Where have you been?
Oh yeah, right. He actually has a pretty substantial pedigree when it comes to coaching talent and ability. And just his resume is pretty impressive, all things considered. He started off in the collegiate circuit and has worked his way up much like a developing player. He was with the USHL with the Green Bay Gambros as their head coach. He was with the Toledo Walleye, which is the ECHL affiliate of the Red Wings, as their head coach.
Yep.
The Iowa Wild as their head coach was... which is the AHL affiliate of the Minnesota Wild. And
you've heard about them if you've watched our Griffins videos.
Right. And he was just recently, for the last 4 years, with the Tampa Bay Lightning as their assistant coach.
Yeah.
So he's got some pretty good experience.
And in that time has won 2 cups with the Tampa Bay. Congratulations to the Colorado Avalanche for winning the 2022 Stanley Cup playoffs. And moving on. So if you're anything like me, you heard Derek Lalonde, and you're like, who? Who's this guy? He looks like Gru from the Despicable Me.
He looks familiar, though.
He went through a 2-month vetting process. So basically, to get all this information, we watched press conferences.
Yeah. We listened to Steve because he's the one who hired him.
As is to be expected for something like this. Everybody was wondering why something wasn't announced sooner because Jeff Blashill was let go early. Like,
it was April.
It was early. I mean, it felt like forever ago. But he was let go pretty recently, and immediately everyone expected a head coach. They expected they have to do it before the draft. They have to do it before this. I don't know why everybody thinks
Steve
like that.
Steve doesn't have to do anything that you want him to.
And, like, they just need him before that season. Even then, he could have an intro.
Yeah, like, be like the week before training camp.
Boom. Head coach.
Bam.
So he went through a 2-month vetting process, as is to be expected with Steve Yzerman. I feel like he's a very methodical GM. He's not going to do anything hastily. We're still in development. We've probably been in development since 16-17, I would say, with the Red Wings. And so it's important to not, we're going to talk about this a little later, to cut corners. And that is not something that we did with getting this coach as far as the time it took, the intentionality behind it, the guys that were talked to previously. Mm-hmm. And obviously, for me, looking at his history in Tampa, it was someone that Yzerman's had his eye on. He was with Tampa when this guy was working with them as well. So he's had his eye on Lalonde for a while, it seems.
Yeah, and Yzerman, I mean, if you look at the rumor mill, I mean, this is the time that a lot of teams are hiring coaches. So it seemed like, you know, coaches were dropping like flies, and just as soon as they dropped, teams would pick them up.
Yeah.
So there was a ton of change.
Recycled
happening.
Coaches.
Recycled
if you
coaches,
will.
Yeah. All NHL coaches.
Yeah.
And that was something that Yzerman, he said during this process, he was looking at coaches from around the world, different leagues, different levels, some with experience, some with no experience. So it's not like it was. I think the canned response and canned ideas, like, oh, we're just going to pick up another one of these NHL coaches. I think a lot of people, ourselves included, have a hard time looking outside of that and seeing potential that is ready, much like players, that he's like, hey, he's ready to take this step. Mm-hmm. And that's something that he trusted John Cooper when John Cooper hired him back in Tampa with Steve. Mm-hmm. And he has grown a lot. And Lalonde even said that John Cooper told him at the time, like, you're ready. You're more than ready. He said that maybe he was past his prime already, just as like a little joke, like he's overripe. But it is a good time for him, and just like he's developed throughout the leagues, this is something where he's coming into a team that he can help develop and develop himself and his coaching ability even further.
Yeah. So something that they want to, as a team, now that we've got the head coach, we have the, you know, the captain of the ship kind of going forward. So now they can start talking about where they see the Red Wings going, what needs to change, what needs to be done. And one of the things that we grasped was their desire for a defensive focus and to be a physical and checking team, which is not something we have right now. So if you look at, just as an example, Tampa Bay, because he's coming from Tampa Bay, if you look at their team, they have strong D. They have very strong guys that can strong arm the puck away from you, but they're also very skilled. So we have we've got guys that are skilled. We're getting guys that are more skilled. We're developing guys that are skilled. We want to make sure that we have a physical game and a very to the boards kind of game, yeah, and a strong defensive game, because if you're getting 60 goal or 60 shots against you in a night,
yeah,
something's going to go in. So if you could neutral zone that, yeah, like, you know, keep it out, that's going to be really important going forward and something that I'm excited to see, you know, yeah, and I think that Sider will be a big part of that. And I think that he's kind of not the shining star, but kind of like, all right, we've got Sider. Let's get some more pieces. Mm-hmm. Let's get some more of our developing D to come alongside, right, and get this core moving.
Yeah. And that's something that's really encouraging to hear that, because it's something as a league or and as an organization, we've all known and seen and we've struggled with it. We, yeah, have very talented players that seem to almost like hit dry spells as soon as they get to the NHL. They just can't produce. They can't keep up. So with the defensive focus and having that checking ability, and like Janae mentioned, like with Tampa, you see that they had a really hard battle in these finals, just, yeah, intensely hard. And I just think of guys like Victor Hedman.
Yes.
Like, the man's a beast.
He's good.
He's a woolly mammoth on skates.
Yep.
But he can play well, but he's also very physical.
Mm-hmm.
And it just finding
their whole team. See, I can't, yeah, think, maybe Cirelli, he's a little less physical, but, yeah, that's the thing. You want a bunch of well-rounded players, and I would love to see a nice physical team. Not, yeah, in the fact that we're like punching guys' lights out every second, right, but
we need to be able to do that.
But we can keep the puck. We can physically keep people, yeah, away. We can get the puck. Yeah. It's very, I would like that.
Yeah, we have a lot of guys, and you've heard us talk about these prospects coming down the pipe. This is where their focus is. They're, yeah, not looking at defensively developing what's there already. We're redoing the team.
Yeah.
It's going to be completely different faces in the next couple seasons. On top of that, Lalonde is, according to Steve Yzerman, he loves the team culture and the relationship-based coaching he has. Now, he's not just a player's coach. He has the relationships. He hears from the guys. Where do you want to improve? Where do
you
see
yourself? Well, he doesn't have them yet, but he's good at cultivating the relationship.
Right. Yeah.
Basically.
Yeah. And that's something, like, he's going to be interviewing every single player individually, he said, and speaking with them about where they believe their shortcomings are and how they can improve the team as a whole, and building a culture and a program around that. And that's something that I think, you know, Blashill did try to do.
Yeah.
But I don't think it was like a perennial thing.
And well, here's the thing too. Blashill was kind of inset when the development had to start. Like, yeah, it was kind of a forced development. Like, all, yeah, right, all of a sudden we're here. We're not doing great. We need to change something.
Yeah.
So he was kind of in the middle of that. So it's easy to kind of stay in that, if you will. And if you can't rise above it, in a sense.
It's hard to change when you're already so far in.
Yeah, so having a new, yeah, set of eyes on it is going to be really exciting. But the thing about all of that and talking to the players and stuff is focusing on the process,
mm-hmm,
and not cutting corners, which is something I mentioned earlier. So something that Lalonde and Yzerman had mentioned was that in Tampa Bay, they had a season three seasons ago or so, where they won a lot of games in the regular season, get to the playoffs, they were crushed. They were just completely demolished because they were focusing a lot on the outcome rather than the process. So how do we get to the playoffs? Mm-hmm. How do we then get through the playoffs? And that's something that Lalonde is going to bring with him. He's been through, of course, many different trials through, mm-hmm, all these coaching experiences he's had. He's improved every team he's been on, which is something that Yzerman has pointed out too, and something that's very important.
Mm-hmm.
So he knows, and he's been there for, you know, the winning in the regular season, getting crushed in the playoffs. He's been there for getting the team ready for the playoffs, through the playoffs, and winning as well. Mm-hmm. You know, of course, him as assistant coach, but right next to John Cooper, what better guy to learn next to?
Exactly. John Cooper is a fantastic
coach.
He's
a good coach.
He's a really good coach. But with the process base, and I know it's something that a lot of people are almost probably sick of hearing.
Like, oh, yeah, trust the process.
Trust the process.
I mean, 2016-17 for developing.
We've been trusting the process for a long time. But this is part of that process. And, yeah, when someone else comes in that has a history of development and he's going to be almost, I think Yzerman said, about 99% responsible for picking the additional coaches he needs. We still need a goaltending, yeah, coach and an assistant coach.
Mm-hmm.
So he's going to be responsible for creating his staff to then make that happen. So that's really refreshing. That's also part of the process. And,
yeah,
I really liked what, you know, in the press conference where he did say that, you know, they had this focus in Tampa where the year that they got crushed in the playoffs, they were so focused on outcome, they forgot the little things that brought them there.
Yeah.
And that's where the process gets
and
lost.
And how to learn from it.
Exactly. And if you lose that in anything that you do, you're not going to have the result that you want,
yeah,
long term and sustainably. So it's really cool because I think You know, we might not be in playoff contention if we are fantastic. That's not the goal yet this season. It's to get the right guys in.
And that doesn't mean if you get to playoffs, you want to take some of the things that you changed and that worked. You want to take those and build upon them. So it's that's when seeing the process is important, because then you can see what you did right, build on it, and change it for next year if you need to. So overall thoughts on this, I will admit I was a little... only because in my head, because he had no NHL coaching experience, for some reason that it stopped it in my brain, kind of like, okay, so we're developing a coach and players now. This is not, it's not like these coaches don't start somewhere, you know? So this is his shot to be NHL head coach, and this is heavy on his mind, I'm sure, too. But I think that he's got the right vein and he's in the right mindset of, let's develop this team. Let's get this team into contention. Mm-hmm. And that's what we really all want as fans. So after hearing about him, after seeing him, I do think it's going to be a nice fit. But we can really only see as things go.
Yeah.
That's the bummer is like, I can't see in the future.
I'm excited to see how he handles training camp, too, because that's where you get to see the coaches and the players at a really raw level. So I'm really excited for that this year.
And... kind of tag teaming it in GR, like our thoughts on GR. What do you think this means for development in Grand Rapids?
We're going to see what you've seen. A lot more movement in Grand Rapids. I think with they didn't directly come out and say, "Oh, our we're going to start."
This is our 3-year plan.
Yeah, they didn't say that. I will say initial thoughts on Lalonde. I really liked how he was very concise in his answers, and it sounds kind of a silly thing, but you can tell he's very methodical in how he does things.
He's thought about it.
Yeah, there's like I was telling Janae off camera where there is. The initial opening, there is the answer to the question, and a close. Like, he has his thoughts very organized, and I think that plays out into how a person leads. Mm-hmm. But overall, with Grand Rapids, I think we're going to see a lot more movement, a lot more communication, perhaps a few switches as far as staffing goes.
I was going to say, even as far as how they develop, because I've often thought that Grand Rapids does a really good job with developing, so I'm excited and... not nervous, but I'm looking forward to seeing what he thinks and the people he's going to bring on thinks is good and bad in Grand Rapids as far as what we need or like what needs to change. And that could be a lot of movement.
It could be. And I think
that's the point, though.
Yeah. I think the starting roster in Grand Rapids is going to be, at least for me, a very good indication of what kind of team we're going to have that season, what their goal is. Because when you see
I'd like to see a physical checking team.
I would love
that
to see it.
That'd be great.
Give me some bodies that can
hard to the boards.
Can beat Chicago.
Yeah, keeping that possession.
Yeah.
It's just, I would like to see the kind of team that he's describing. Yeah. That would be great. Yeah. And I do think that the guys we have coming and even some of the guys that we have now who aren't drafted and who have been drafted, I think they're going to be good fits for that. But it might involve also like a change of what's expected from the players.
Which I think there should be. Yeah. And I think there's a point, I'm not saying Grand Rapids is guilty of this, but there is a point where they can get a little comfortable with who's around them and what the expectations are.
Well, how can you not? I mean...
exactly. you fall into this routine.
Yeah.
And I think shaking things up a little bit will be a good thing for them. But I am interested to see how hard they push, what their expectations are, and how frequent their presence is.
Yeah.
So, like, when Eisenman came
on
board...
Oh, yeah, how often they come.
Yeah. You get a really good vibe of how the team is. It's like, during when we didn't have weird seasons, how many scouts were there, how many coaches staff from Detroit were there, and how many people with Detroit lapel pins were there.
Yeah.
And you're like, oh, okay, something's going on and we need to pay attention here. So I think there's going to be a lot more of that.
Yeah. So in conclusion, I think it's going to be a good fit. And again, we can't know until the season starts, until it starts coming. But do temper expectations as far as like, this doesn't mean we're getting into the playoffs, and you might not think we would anyway, but it's just... let's see how it goes. Let's see how it develops. And I'm excited just because it's a new face. I'm excited to see the kind of changes that are going to happen. We'll be keeping our eye on that for sure.
Yeah.
Also, special shout out to Brad Thompson, the equipment manager for the Grand Rapids Griffins. I think 25 years now.
26.
25, 26.
Yeah.
Should know that. No. So sorry.
Sorry, dog.
He won the Career Achievement Award. Yeah. So that's super great. Super exciting. He deserves all of it.
In front of all of us.
To know dog is to know a good friend. So.
That's true.
Congratulations, dog, and let us know in the comments what you think about the new head coach and how you kind of see it playing out in the future. Mm-hmm. What kind of prospects are you looking forward to see? Because you know what? Development camp's coming.
Yes.
Prospect camp is coming, and most importantly, currently, draft day is coming. So keep on the lookout, because next week we'll do a video on who we pick.
Yes.
And how he fits and how wrong we were in all our predictions.
Yeah, well,
maybe we're on it.
We were probably right.
There's a chance.
There's a 1 in 10 chance. We're right. Maybe. I may have won in 300.
Yeah, who knows. Anyway, let us know. Remember to like and subscribe. Thank you so much again for watching, and we will see you guys next week. Bye.